In the London borough of Hackney, in the early hours of the 22nd of July, 2017, a police officer pursued a young black man into a convenience store. Within minutes, the young man was dead. His name was Rashan Charles. He was 20 years old, the eldest of seven children, a father with a daughter nearly 2 years old. The day after Rashan's death, the Metropolitan Police claimed he had been taken ill after trying to swallow an object. Rashan had tucked a package inside his mouth. It was later found to have contained caffeine and paracetamol. The police claimed he tried to swallow the package and that an officer had intervened to prevent Rashan from harming himself.
Well, I see a police officer coming into a store and Rashan moving into the store quite fast.
This is Rod Charles, Rashan's great uncle. In 2014, he retired at the rank of chief inspector after 30 years with the Metropolitan Police.
Well, the right thing for the officer to do is to pursue and to locate and ideally detain the person he suspects. He has a decision to make. Do I go forward and detain? Do I communicate from distance to the individual? You could easily say, stand still, show me your hands, turn around. But the officer says nothing. The officer simply goes forward and physically engages Rashan. Rashan is thrown over to the left on the side and the officer ends up falling to ground on top of Rashan. It isn't a rear takedown. There is no controlled descent. Nobody has ever tendered any evidence, nor can they tender evidence that Rashan used any force whatsoever. The officer was not at fear of harm from Rashan because he threatened nothing to the officer, and likewise, no member of the public nearby was threatened by Rashan.
A second man joins the uniformed officer. The police said he was a member of the public.
What causes me concern is that he positions himself on top of Rashan and remains astride Rashan for over 3 minutes, probably closer to 4 minutes. He seems to have taken control of the scene.
A few months after Rashan died, police lawyers persuaded a coroner to grant anonymity, so we're not allowed to tell you who these men are. We have to call the uniformed police officer BX47. We can't name the member of the public. We have to call him Witness One.
I have been assisted, and I've seen officers assisted by members of the public before, but I've never seen a shift in control of scenes where people question who is in charge here. And the footage has caused many people to think, well, is the officer in control of this or is the member of the public? Some have even said, is that a member of the public? Because the level of involvement is such, they think, some people think he's an undercover police officer. I don't, but I do think that Bravo X-47 panicked and lost control. Witness One puts pressure on Rashan's back, and as Rashan is pushed back toward the ground, his eyes are staring up, and to me, Rashan is panicking. Rashan is in clear distress. Then they apply handcuffs, but as soon as the handcuffs go on, you can see that Rashan's right hand is limp, and handcuffs are applied to a person who is not resisting. And even if you didn't know, even if they didn't know that he was limp and motionless at that time, the handcuffs stay on for 3 minutes and 44/45 seconds. It's a long time to remain on a person who is in distress.
Medical experts who viewed the footage believe that Rashan likely died there on the floor of the convenience store. A copy of the shop's CCTV footage first showed up on YouTube and was later circulated on Twitter. People were outraged and small protests erupted in East London.
You killed Rashan!
Police killed Rashan!
You killed Rashan!
In July 2018, an inquest concluded that Rashan's death was accidental and that the use of force had been justified. A month later, the IOPC reported that they had found Officer BX47 to have no case to answer on 4 counts relating to misconduct. Rashan's family called the IOPC investigation flawed from the outset, and they said that the inquest was a farce.
This case hinges on what happened in a matter of 3 or 4 minutes in a convenience store on the 22nd of July, 2017, and it hinges on the appropriateness or the inappropriateness of the use of force by the police officer when he engaged Rashan. Yet we spent many hours in the inquest talking about Rashan's lifestyle, and a caricature was created of him as a major organized criminal. This is a young man who doesn't have a great deal of money, doesn't have a significant source of income, doesn't own his own massive house anyway, he lives in council premises. Rashan died on the 22nd of July. Bravo X-ray 47 was not subject to a formal interview until December. He would have viewed that CCTV on open source YouTube several times, and that will impact upon what you're going to say in interview. I don't believe for a moment, and neither does my family, that the officer set out to cause a fatality that day when he began his tour of duty. This is not a vilification of that individual. This is about a proper scrutiny, a proper investigation and justice. And we've seen anything but so far.
Since our interview with Rod Charles, we've examined more footage from the convenience store. We'll leave you with some interactions between two police officers and the member of the public, Witness One. These encounters happened while close by paramedics worked on Rashan. Here's Witness One beckoning to BX-47. BX-47 immediately approaches, stepping over Rashan's feet to join him in the aisle. Witness One shows BX-47 a card from his wallet. The officer writes in his notebook. The two men clasp hands. At the inquest into Rashan's death, both BX-47 and Witness One said under oath that they had never met before the fatal incident. The family's barrister asked Witness One if he felt that BX-47 had assisted him. Witness One replied, "I feel 47 was not 100%. He was tired. He was not himself." Here is another officer at the scene. He's holding two evidence bags. One bag appears to contain some small personal items of Rashan's, and the other contains the package that paramedics removed from his airway. This officer approaches Witness One, shows him the evidence bags, and they talk. What are we to make of these encounters? Rashan Charles was one of six black men who died during or after police restraint in England over 9 months from June 2017. As well as Rashan, there was Edson Da Costa, Darren Cumberbatch, Shane Bryant, Nuno Cardoso, and Kevin Clark.